What is going on, everybody? Kevin here from SportsBoxBreaks.com, coming to you live Monday night, December 19th, 2016. We are doing 2016-17 Don Russ Basketball Choose Team Half Case Break Number 3. This is who we have. Atlanta Hawks going to Ryan B. Boston Celtics, Kyle W. Brooklyn Nets, Kyle W. Charlotte Hornets, Paul H. That one was sold double at the end. And Paul's order came in just seconds before. I know we already worked it out in the chat, but I just wanted to say it on the video here as well. So again, Charlotte Hornets goes to Paul H. Chicago Bulls goes to Ryan B. Cleveland Cavs, Mark H. Dallas Mavs, Ryan B. Denver Nuggets going to Ryan B. Detroit Pistons, Adam P. Golden State Warriors, Mark H. Houston Rockets go to Chris P. Indiana Pacers go to Ryan B. LA Clippers, Ryan B. LA Lakers, Justin V. Memphis Grizzlies, Ryan B. Miami Heat, Ryan B. Ryan B stepped up on a bunch of these teams today, guys, and really, really pushed the effort for us. So again, I can't thank you enough, Ryan, and also Kyle and everybody else. So again, last one I said was Miami Heat for Ryan B. Milwaukee Bucks, Mark H. Minnesota T-Wolves go to Ryan B. The Pelicans, the New Orleans Pelicans go to Ryan B. New York Knicks go to Glenn C. Oklahoma City Thunder, Kyle W. Orlando Magic, Kyle W. Philadelphia 76ers, also Kyle W. The Phoenix Suns, Ryan B. Portland Trailblazers, Ryan B. Sacramento Kings, Ryan B. San Antonio Spurs, Kyle W. Toronto Raptors, Justin V. Utah Jazz, Kyle W. And the Washington Wizards going Ryan B. All right, that does it, guys. Let me get my, let me get this going. That one, the SBB cash thing was the weekend, Ryan. That one was on the weekend. I apologize if there's any confusion on that one, guys. That one was a weekend deal. We put it out there on Friday. Ugh. One sec here, guys. Let me get my garbage can in front of me. Yeah, we put that out there on Friday, and surprisingly, we just did not get a lot of good momentum on it. So we that one ran Friday through Sunday, that promo, the SBB cash thing. We only had a couple participants actually step up on some spots on that one on Friday and Saturday, which was surprising because that was a really good deal. All right, guys, there's a lot of cards to get through here. A lot of cards to get through. Let's start here. Let me pull this whole mat a little. It weighs about, oh, man. There we go. Here we go. Starting here, guys. Let me flip these this way. Yep, that'll work. All right. We're going to open all the packs, then we're going to work through them. But we will have more promos. In fact, I was thinking of putting another promo up on the site this week. Again, we're just so overloaded with inventory right now that we've been throwing a lot of promos out there to see which ones get best traction. And, the 25% one we were doing a while ago, that one got good traction. The cash back one did not get good traction for whatever reason. I think guys like to see a physical coupon they can plug in and see the discount versus just getting cash back. I don't know. It's a study of consumerism, right? Study of buying trends. Fastball Freddy, save 10 coupon code works for everything lined up tonight, bud. Everything tonight, save 10. So high tech is getting closer. It's at 11. So if you want to jump in any of those high tech spots, Freddy, there you go. Appreciate that, Paul. You the man. Paul's helping it out. Giving a little promotion in the chat there. Much appreciated. All right. Here we go. One sec, guys. Okay. Sorry about that. All right. Here's one. You know, I'm going to do it like this. Let's keep the momentum or keep the anticipation high. I'm going to actually crack open all these packs in one shot. Cracking them open in one shot. But Ryan, I'll see what I can do on the cash back stuff. We'll flip you a little something back for stepping up on all these teams, bud. I don't want you to feel like you thought you were getting a promotional deal and then we're pulling the rug out from under you, because we certainly don't want you to feel like that. So Carl Anthony Towns, I don't know what it is. We'll see in a minute. Maybe a base, maybe more than a base. But I will. At the end of the night tonight, I'll look and I'll see what we can work up for you, even though that promotion is officially not in effect any longer, but we'll hook you up, bud. Because Ryan really got this one filled. Kyle stepped up on some as well. Thank you, Paul. Much appreciated on the acknowledgement there, bud. Much appreciated. No problem, Ryan. Thinking about the promotion, I didn't really put a clear definition in place as far as when it was over. It started on Friday, but there was no real clear definition on there when it was over. So I don't like there to be ambiguous wording on those promo deals. Maybe so. Lots of good stuff to be seen in this one. So that's, I really wish that I had some type of unboxing or unwrapping machine. Guys, just to point out too, those of you that are watching this on YouTube, I just want to show, I didn't really mention it. So this is a 10 box half case break. This is the way these were sold. I just unboxed all of one box of them. You can see the other 9 boxes sitting behind. If you want to actually see the physical case opening, go back to break number 1. That was the other 10 boxes. I had that particular case here. And break number 1 was done at this location. So this is the second half of it. Even though it's break number 3, these are the other 10 boxes. So just to point that out, there is a backwards card, which is going to indicate something. And it looks like it's going to be the Celtics coming up on that one. So let's see. Let's start here. Let me get a focus or an autofocus off and get a nice crisp, crisp focus point. Yep, second half of the full case. All right, guys, let's keep it going. I'm looking for and guys, if you see me pass anything off, and I say this all the time, if you see me pass anything off that is something you want brought back into the camera view, just give me a little shout in the chat and I will certainly bring those cards back into the camera view. I'm just trying to keep at it at a good pace. I already forget what I'm looking for in this stuff. That's how I did the first case or the first break of it, and Jason did the second. And I'm completely forgetting. Chris Paul, the Elite Series. I'm completely forgetting what I'm looking for. So, again, give me a shout. Trickster, this is break number 3. This is break number 3. Don Russ Basketball, break 3. This one is the one that filled up tonight. All right, guys, here we go. We got a hit coming up. Check it out. Tom Satch Sanders for the Celtics. Hall Dominator. That's a pretty cool old school card right there. Tom Satch Sanders for the Boston Celtics. Auto. So the Boston Celtics score in the first one here. And check out the numbering here, guys. I was looking for it. I didn't see exactly where it was. That's a 5 out of 10. That's a 5 out of 10. Press proof on the bottom left. Yes, yes, that is right. So the Boston Celtics in this one. That's Kyle. That's K-Dubs. K-Dubs picking up some Satch action. That sounds a little weird, but that's what's happening. K-Dubs picking that up. So the press proofs I'm looking for as well. Yes, that is right. I swear to God, I'm zoning out as far as like what this product is all about. It's been a little bit since we broke the first one. So I'm looking for the press proofs. I'm looking for any kind of numbered cards. I'm looking for autos. The champ is here, LeBron. There's a bunch of these in here. We got a George Hill, Utah Jazz. This one is to 99. So Utah Jazz to 99 on that one. Our hit classification, guys, is a 50 or better card, anything with an auto on it, anything that obviously has a relic piece, a memorabilia piece on it. Got a Porzingis Court Kings. But like I said, if you want to see something brought back into view, just give me a little nudge in the chat and I will certainly bring it back into view. All right, here we go. We got a little rookie. Oh, they're falling. Rookie Kings press proof for the Suns. Rookie Kings press proof for the Suns. Not numbered on that press proof, but still just to point it out. Again, guys, thanks so much for filling this one up. You guys rock. Got a Court Kings, Karl Anthony Towns, T-Wolves. Court Kings, Karl Anthony Towns, not numbered. So I'm sure you guys that are buying into this particular product understand what these cards. A lot of guys look at this stuff and they're like, oh, there's not a ton of autos or whatever. Check this out. What? That's a Wiggins press proof 10 out of 10. So eBay one of one on the numbering, 10 out of 10 press proof of Wiggins. Boom. That's a little boom action right there. That snuck up out of nowhere. Minnesota T-Wolves, 10 out of 10 Wiggins. Press proof. Who's got them? Who's got them? Who's got them? That is Ryan B. Ryan B getting some love right there, buddy. Notorious getting some love on the Wiggins right behind it. Elite Series, AD. Boom, boom, boom. Guys, last year, we had a crowd of guys that were coming in and filling up our basketball breaks. I swear, we were able to fill up a basketball break at night. There were so many guys coming in buying basketball. That crowd has faded out a little bit. You guys, however, that are in tonight seem to be into... What? I don't know what it is yet, Ryan. But that's another Wiggins coming our way. I'll continue my train of thought once we see what this Wiggins is all about. That's a Jersey Kings. Jersey Kings of Wiggins. So Wiggins, back-to-back hits. Jersey Kings of Wiggins, not numbered. Little relic piece there. But as I was saying, our crowd last year was all into basketball. I guess it depends on the season, but if you guys are into basketball, got a press proof here, DeMar DeRozan for the Raptors to 199, and can guarantee that you're going to participate in these breaks and fill up these breaks. We'll keep the basketball breaks alive. We will keep them going. We plan on it anyway, but I'm saying like we'll pick up more than one or two cases. Yep, what a start. Pablo Hack is saying, check this out, guys. Dimes of Steph Curry. Dimes of Steph Curry. But we kind of need a little bit of, we'll definitely fill those breaks up if you guys line them up. Otherwise, the same kind of thing happens where we sit on some of these cases. Like right now, we're sitting on Court Kings, which is pretty shocking considering that that is a good product. I know it is maybe isn't this year's version of it, isn't the favorite yet. But press proof David Robinson Hall Kings. This year's may not have been the favorite one out of all the releases of Court Kings, but in previous years, that stuff has flew off the shelf. So it's like hit or miss on a lot of this stuff, you know? Okay, here we go. Second stack of High Society coming out of box number one. So we have to do that times 20. So what we just went through times 20. Oh boy. I'm glad I have my 14-ounce coffee mug. All right. Rookie Kings, Jaylen Brown. Guys, High Tech is at 11. Have I mentioned that? Let's keep that one going. High Tech at 11. We got another press proof here. Tyson Chandler, Phoenix Suns. That's to 299. Got a Court Kings, Russell Westbrook. All right, all right. Let's see. There you go. Pablo Hack, you, my friend. That's what I like to see. That's awesome. Doing us some promotion. doing some promotion for us. Guys, I said it a couple days ago. I don't know who was hanging out with me here at the particular time I was talking about it, but I think the beginning part of the year, we're going to roll out a an affiliate program where you can basically get SBB store credit, which you can use the same as cash to buy into our breaks by referring customers our way that make purchases. Not just referring them, but when they come in, they actually have to make some purchases to qualify for your own credit on the site. So be looking for that. We'll roll out a big announcement on that one, probably beginning part of the year, maybe even late January, actually, because a bunch of stuff going on. We got an All-Stars Larry Bird. All-Stars Larry Bird. But that's a pretty exciting new development. I've actually have a lot of experience in the affiliate marketing world, so this will be interesting to kind of roll it and fold it into SBB along with our breaking crowd. Everybody likes something for free, so hey, how about some free break credit if you guys refer some qualified customers our way that we'll make a purchase? Press proof to $199 for the Nuggets. Guys, I remember doing this in the first case. There's a lot of upside down, right side up, flipped cards in this stuff. So watch, the second I say, oh, you know what, let me flip this up, I guarantee I go through like two cards. And there it is. I go through two cards and then they flip back to the other rotation. So it's almost not worth doing it unless it's a card that we really want to look at, like a press proof or something numbered. So here's a Hall Kings, Bob McAdoo for the Knicks. So what I'm saying is I'm going to keep just blazing through them, even if they're upside down orientation. And we could see if there's a press proof or a numbering on them. And I'll flip those right side up so we can look at them a little closer. But just to keep it going. Press proof right here, Marcus Gasol, Memphis Grizzlies. That's the $299. $299 on this press proof. Toss out in the chat, what players are you guys looking for? If you're sitting on your teams, there's an Anthony Davis All-Stars. Pretty cool card. Anthony Davis All-Stars. Who are you guys looking for? Throw that karma out in the chat. Let's see if we can fulfill something. Got a Crashers, Hassan Whiteside. Hassan Whiteside, Crashers for Miami. And finishing off box number one right here. What do we got? So what are there? What is there, I should say? Look for the Ultra Rare Optic review on Stunning Optichrome Technology. One autograph and one memorabilia card per box on average. Okay, so the Wiggins and the... And the Boston Auto was what we pulled as hits. The rest of it is gravy, right? The Wiggins memorabilia. Got a rookie Kings for the Cavs. The Wiggins 10 out of 10 was gravy. That was an awesome little card. All right, we got a spacer right there. We got a Aaron Gordon for the Magic, press proof to $199. All right, that does it right there. Paul H., you, sir. I love it. I love it. Paul's even promoting the Facebook page for us. Guys, we do a lot of social media. In case you did not know, we're all over social media. Twitter is probably our most actively seen social media platform just because it's not filtered. Like, Facebook is filtered. So we could post things all day on Facebook. Chances are you're only going to see, like, one-tenth of them. Maybe not even one-tenth of them. Maybe fewer than that. So Twitter is usually what we promote. Facebook, we also have a pretty good following there as well. But if you look in the top left here, my finger looked right there. SBB is social. So at SBB Tweet is our Twitter. And then Facebook.com/SportsBoxBreaks and the number one. So SportsBoxBreaks and the number one is our Facebook. But you will see probably the most visibly, like, what we're up to if you follow us on Twitter. All right. Now we just got to do that 10 times. What took us the length of time on that first box? 9 more times. Here we go. Let me flip them. Flip them like that. Is that how I want to do them? Yeah. I like to flip them so that the flap on the pack is, like, right there and I can just pop them open. I remember Jason for the longest time when he would break, and he breaks faster than I do, because I could chit-chat forever, but Jason, when he breaks, or still to this day, a lot of times when he breaks, He will do one pack at a time. Show the whole pack and then go to the next one. Show the whole pack, go to the next one. I don't know. That's not my style. I can't do it. That would be super cool, Pablo Hack. That would be super cool. Where's their manufacturing facility located? Do you know? I don't even know. Funny thing, where we're located, we're just outside of Scranton, PA. So if you've ever watched The Office on NBC, which has been off the air for, you know, several years now, but The Office fictionally took place right in our hometown here. But Topps Company has headquarters. Like, if you go to Topps website and you have to contact their customer service, they're located right here in our backyard in Scranton, PA. They used to produce here as well, but now they don't. Now they just have their customer service offices there, and they have manufacturing facilities here locally for for some of their candy product, like Ring Pops. So Topps Company actually does Ring Pops, and they produce the Ring Pops here locally. But if you need to contact Topps customer service or send them something, you're actually calling right here to Scranton. Which is pretty funny. I actually know a few people that work there. Yep, The Office. Yeah, The Office was awesome. And the funny thing is, they did a really good job with the show The Office in terms of keeping actual local references peppered into the show. So like every episode, they would pretty much mention something or go to some location that really is in Scranton. It wouldn't necessarily be the actual physical place here in Scranton because they wouldn't film on location, but they would mention bars. And back when the show was in its heyday, the prop master from NBC would come to one of the malls here locally once a year, and if you had a small business, you would be able to go there and submit stuff to the prop master that could get put on the show. So that was kind of a neat little thing to keep the local thing going. $25 redemptions in waiting. Wow. We had a case of, what the heck was it? Bowman Chrome Baseball. That they shorted us half the autos in it. Just recently. I reached out to them. I thought for sure, I'm like, okay, we work through these wholesale distributors. Reaching out through the wholesale distributors got to have a better effect in terms of getting this taken care of quicker than going directly to Topps customer service. So I reached out to our wholesale distributor. She worked on it for 2 weeks and then all of a sudden came back and told me they couldn't do anything, that I'd have to contact Topps customer service directly myself. I went to my second wholesale distributor. Worked through them. They couldn't get anything done for me. So I reached out to Topps directly myself. They had the replacement autos in my hand within 3 days. I'm like, why didn't I just do this to begin with? Which I was shocked. I thought for sure I was going to get stonewalled and it was going to take 2 months more from Topps customer service. And again, guys, I'm not going to worry about flipping the card orientation to the right side up because they just flip back like right there. It goes right to the Rookie Kings, Phoenix Suns. Rookie Kings, Murray, Spurs, not numbered. Keeping it going, guys. Keeping it going. Guys, we're now down to 10 in high tech. We are approaching that single-digit number. We got an Elite Series, Anthony Davis right here. Elite Series. Yeah, it was right when Bowman came out, so within the last couple months. And they did the replacement autos for us probably just a little over a month ago. So they actually, if you buy full cases or boxes and you know they shorted you an amount of autos, we got a hit coming up here, guys. What do we got? Let's do a slow reveal on it. Slow reveal time. Do-do-do. That is a Malcolm Brogdon. Is it Brogdon? Milwaukee Bucks. That is a newly crowned, a little jersey relic piece going on here. So the Milwaukee Bucks on the board, newly crowned. There's one. So we'll have an auto in here. Let's see if we could pull something big in terms of numbering, too. Well, I didn't even call them. I sent it in. I actually sent like whenever they screw something up, got a press proof to 299. When they screw something up, they have like a damage slash claim form that I had to fill out, and then I had to send them some of the physical packaging from the product, like some of the empty packs. Got a Dimes Ricky Rubio, T-Wolves. I had to send them some of the packs. I had to send them one of the retail, like the boxes, the hobby boxes, and even the UPC code off the side of the case. Once I got all that together and I sent it to them signature confirmation, so I knew it got in somebody's hands. Got a Holiday Pelicans to 199 press proof. Within 3 days, they had the replacement autos in my hand. It was actually pretty impressive. The replacement autos were nothing to brag about. They were just all base autos, but got a press proof. I almost missed it. Dellavedova, Milwaukee Bucks press proof to 299. Trickster's calling out. What are you calling for? Awesome. Let's see if we can score for you, Trickster. Let's see. The champ is here. Magic Johnson hugging that trophy. All right, spacer right there, guys. Yeah, I mean, if you have a working relationship with like a representative inside of Topps or Panini, that works as well. I didn't. 53 out of 299, which you would think as much product as we buy, we would have a direct contact with a rep, but we don't buy direct. We buy through wholesalers. In order to buy direct off Topps, you have to, I don't know, a million a year, something crazy. All-Stars Drummond. You have to spend like a million a year, and you have to have a physical brick and mortar local card shop like presence. Nowitzki, Court Kings, which we do not have, nor do we want to have, because we are not, we're selling breaks on the internet. So to take on the cost of having a brick and mortar presence isn't really worth it for us. Again, guys. The second I do the orientation of moving these cards right side up, it doesn't make sense to even do. We got a press proof to 299, Denver Nuggets. And what do we got here? What do we got here? A little Carmelo Court Kings action. Carmelo. Watch here. I put them right side up. I guarantee I'm going to flip through five cards. There they are. And right to the opposite orientation they go. Spacer. What do we got here? 13 out of 99. Toronto Raptors. Norman Powell. Ben Simmons. K-Dubs is calling out for a Simmons. Let's see if we can do it. Let's see if we can do it. We're not even two boxes in out of 10. So we got a lot of potential coming up. Crashers. Randall for the Lakers. John Wall, All Stars, Washington. Where's that auto? Where's that auto? It's coming up. We got a Bryce Johnson, Rookie Kings for the Clippers. Thought I saw a card facing the opposite way, which would indicate the auto, but. It was just this guy right here, Russell Westbrook, Elite Series for Oklahoma City. And again, guys, here it comes. Here it comes. What do we have? We got a Dirk Nowitzki auto, Timeless Treasures for the Mavericks. What do we got? Ooh, baby. That's not just an auto. That's nice. That is a 48 out of 49. 48 out of 49. Very nice. Dirk Nowitzki, Dallas Mavs. Who's got them Mavs? That's Ryan B. Notorious RB picking up another nice one right there. Booyah. Booyah. So you got, not only do you got the ink, you got a little relic piece going on there too. Timeless Treasures. Let's get some hitless teams up there. Let's get some nice low numbered crazy stuff going on here. Press proof to 299 for the Magic. Guys, there was like Kyle was hanging out last night. I think Ryan was hanging out last night as well. three one of ones across a couple breaks that we did. Two one of ones, two button cards came out of Elite Edition Extra, or whatever the heck it's called. Court Kings, Kevin Durant. I can never say it out of the first time. Elite Extra Edition Baseball. One quad panel relic with two buttons. It's a one of one. And then another dual relic with button. I mean, crazy stuff. The fourth case of that is on the site at the moment. So that is, I believe the third and the fourth are up there. So if you guys like that stuff, I'll be looking to do that later in the week. Over the weekend, it's going to run into the holiday. We're going to bump right into Christmas. Pablo, the Kool-Aid man, that's pretty awesome. We got a rookie Kings for the Lakers right there. All right, that does it for box number two. One sec, guys. Got all kinds of base I need to organize in my little base buckets. Hang tight for just a sec. Organizing all my base. And taking a sip of this lovely coffee out of my Las Vegas mug. All right, here we go. Box number three. Guys, if you're hanging out with us for the first time on either Breakers or Twitch, do make sure to follow our channel. Real easy to do. Click the follow button. Got a little heart on it if you're watching us on Breakers. If you're watching us on Twitch, it's right under the video as well. Do follow us. Makes a big difference in getting this stuff filled up. You'll get a notification when we go live. We'll also move up in the rankings on these nights when we are live, which get more folks in the door, potentially more spots picked up, more breaks filled up, and so on. So it's a big effort. Need those followers for that to happen, though. Guys, High Tech Baseball, 10 spots. Bowman Draft Jumbo, 16. Court Kings Basketball, 17. Totally Certified Basketball, 17. So what else can we do tonight? I would love to see that High Tech fill up by the time we finish this break. We do have more of it, too. So High Tech break number four is not our last. Weird thing about High Tech is it stalled out. Like, we actually broke through and got a bunch of it filled up real quick, and then all of a sudden it just, like, stalled out. But it's a direct result of how many new releases have been coming out back to back. When there's so many new releases coming out, it takes the focus off of even releases that came out 2 weeks ago. You know, there's so many new ones coming out right behind it that it just takes the focus right off them. Almost halfway through the opening of the packs anyway. Okay. Half of the packs open. Half of them open. Here comes the next. Don Russ Basketball. So when was the Don Russ label brand its own brand prior to Topps acquisition? 90s? 80s? 90s? What was the year? When did Topps actually acquire the Don Russ? Or I'm sorry, Panini rather. Duh, not Topps. Panini. One, two, three packs still to crack open here. Huh. high tech last week. Flip it for a decent amount on eBay. Those are one out of every 96 boxes. Awesome, Ryan. Awesome. Very cool. Well, in case you didn't hear, Rye, high tech baseball break number four sitting at 10 spots. Just saying. Looking to do that one next. All right, here we go. Here we go. The first case of high tech had some pretty good stuff in it. Or first case, last previous case, I should say, because we're actually into break number four of that stuff at the moment. So, previous case that I did here had some pretty good stuff. All right, let's see what we got. Got a Hall Kings, Moses Malone, pretty cool. So I think it was last year. I can't remember what product it was. We're sitting here and we're like doing one of the things, and like these are clearly, I don't know if they're artist portraits over a photograph or if they're actually just artist portraits, but we're doing a football product, a Topps football product, and I can't remember which one it is. And the one guy comes into the chat and he's watching the break and he's participating in the chat and he's talking about it. We got a John Wall, Washington Wizards /99, and he's like, "Yeah, I'm the artist that did those portraits." It was a football. It was a Topps football product last year, and I'm like, yeah, whatever. And he actually fires a YouTube video link. Got a Court Kings Drummond for the Pistons. He fires a YouTube link into the chat, and sure enough, it was a YouTube video of him being a graphic artist and doing the artwork for this particular Topps product. He just so happened to stumble upon our Breakers channel while we were doing a live break of one of the products that he was one of the artists for. Got an All Stars of Aldridge. I thought that like blew me away. I was like, really? How does this even happen? But that was super cool. All right, got a Kyrie. The champ is here. There's a spacer right there. Got a Reggie Jackson, Mr. Baseball. Oh, that's the wrong sport, wrong guy, wrong everything. But that's the 49, so that's pretty cool. That's a blue /49 for the Pistons. Booyah. Paul, I know you're relatively new with us. Just out of curiosity, did you find us here through Breakers or did you find us through eBay? How did you originally come upon us? Got an All Stars of Kawhi Leonard. Okafor press proof /299, or even Google searching. I guess a lot of folks actually find us doing Google searches. All right, we got a Crashers of Randall for the Lakers. Keeping it going, guys. Keeping it going. I am gonna need more coffee after this coffee, that is for sure. Rookie, what do we got? Rookie Kings. Rookie Kings for the Sacramento Kings. Got a Hall Kings of Dominique. Hall Kings, Dominique. All right, last but not least out of the first stack. What did we pull so far? We didn't pull anything. So we have two hits still to be revealed in this box, don't we? Two hits still to be revealed. We got a press proof here. Press proof of Bryce Johnson for the Clippers /299. Okay, they got to be hiding in this stack. They've got to be hiding all up in these cards right here. Let's see. Got a Hall Kings of James Worthy. Elite Series Jimmy Butler for the Bulls. All right, here we go. Here we go. First one coming at us. Dominator Jabari Parker for the Bucks. What do we got? Booyah. Jabari Parker Dominator Auto. Check out the numbering. If you can see it, that's a 3 out of 10. 3 out of 10 on that one. That is fantastic. Jabari Parker for the Milwaukee Bucks. I believe, I don't want to say the wrong name, but I believe, ooh, I'm wrong. Milwaukee Bucks in this one. That's Mark H. I was ready to say Ryan. The Bucks in this one belong to Mark H. There you go. Good case. Trickster is liking it. I'm liking it. So congrats there, Mark H. Good stuff. Good stuff. All right, all right. Dallas Mavs, Williams to 99. Yeah, I mean, the autos have a little more meat on them. The one had the relic piece. You got some low numbering going on. I like it. I like it a lot. Yeah, K-Dubs is saying the same exact thing. I just noticed you said the same exact thing that I said. It's nice when it's all there, right? All the pieces, not just base autos and stuff like that, but you're getting low numbers. You're getting, what do we got here? What do we got here? What's the significance of the background and stuff on that one? It's obviously different. It's an optic. Oh, that's what it is. That's the optic, right? All right. Keeping it going. As it says, what does it say? Look for ultra-rare optic preview on stunning OptiChrome technology. I'm just looking at the top of the box there. Yeah, there's a lot of stuff going on in this product. I don't even know a tenth of it. I'm just trying to show you guys the cards and let you guys actually see what you see. Court Kings of Jeremy Lin, Brooklyn Nets. And keeping it going. Elite Series, LaMarcus Aldridge. There's a Ben Simmons base. Excuse me, my voice is shot. And what do we got? Here comes a Swatch Kings. Swatch Kings, Russell Westbrook for Oklahoma City. Who's got the Oklahoma City spot in this one? Oklahoma City Thunder is K-Dubs. What do we got for you, buddy? Not too bad. Russell Westbrook, Swatch Kings, Thunder, and that is an 88 out of 99. 88 out of 99 on the numbering. All right. Those are our official two hits. Let's see what else we can score here in low numbers or variations or crazy stuff. Got a press proof. Press proof. Rockets. Dimes of Chris Paul for the Clippers. All right, we're almost there. Box number three is almost officially in the books here. We got a Lillard Press Proof Elite Series, Portland. No numbering on that one. All right, guys, one sec, organizing up the base, and we're going to rip into box four. I like it. It's a good one so far. I'm digging it. And to be honest, it's not killing me too bad as far as getting through all these cards. The nice part about these cards and any of these heavy base products is we actually, because Jay and I do this as a one-man, or really a two-man show, so we don't have any additional folks working with us. We are two people doing this operation from start to finish. We did just start taking on some help with the sorting when it comes to these real heavy base products. So that we've gotten some help on, but aside from that, we do it all ourselves. Guys, I'll be back in one sec. One sec. I literally had to pour more coffee because I am needing something for my throat. All right, next box, box number four coming up right now. Now I need to take a sip of that coffee. There we go. We're here in the frigid Northeast, and let me tell you, it is frigid. And I think the seasonal cold is starting to maybe start reaching me. The optic card was the case hit, is that right, Trickster? I know just from looking at the top of the box there, it does say look for the ultra rare optic preview on stunning OptiChrome technology. I know they're not numbered, so we don't consider them a quote unquote hit per se. But yeah, they might be one per case. One per case, I guess. So pretty cool. All right, here we go. Box number four. And guys, thanks for coming out, Trickster. I know you've been coming out and kind of hanging out for a little bit each night, waiting to see if your case is going off. Greatly appreciated. Guys, the patience is really appreciated. I mean, you have a lot of product out there up for sale. It's tough to sell through cases of product. Don't let guys fool you. Don't let other breakers fool you into thinking that this stuff can be filled up in one day. Usually cannot. It takes a while, especially when you're sitting on 30 or 40 products on the site at one time. If you're sitting on one case and you're putting all your efforts into that one case, then maybe you can get it filled up in one day. But we have more of a business thing going on here rather than just a small one or two case operation. So it does take a while to get filled because there's a lot of stuff getting filled at the same time. So we do appreciate the patience when some of this stuff doesn't fill up as quickly as you might want it to. We'd love to see, you know, five breaks, six breaks go off per night. But realistically, it usually doesn't happen. Sometimes we've had those kind of nights. Hey, Johnny, what's up there, bud? I am breaking right now Donruss Basketball case break number three. Donruss Basketball case break number three going off right now. The link that's just being posted in the chat right there, if you follow that link, that'll take you to everything else we're trying to get filled up tonight. You'll see High Tech Baseball is sitting at 10. So I'd love to crack into that one next. And we do have some coupon codes in effect tonight. Save 10 coupon code will get you 10% off. So if you're looking to jump into High Tech or any of the other breaks on tonight's lineup, you can use that coupon code for 10%, and the prices have actually already been reduced. So you're kind of double dipping, getting a double discount reduction on the prices already, and you can use the code. Are you in this one, Johnny? Are you in the Donruss break, Donruss Basketball? Paul, thank you, buddy. Much appreciated. And that is true, guys. Really, do your homework. Do your homework and realize that a lot of guys on breakers are doing individual box breaks or just a couple box loose boxes. We do full cases, unless otherwise indicated. This one was a half case break, but most stuff on our website is full case breaks. There are some guys selling single box breaks for like $8 and only sending you the hits. We will a lot of times sell you a full 8-box or a 12-box case break for like maybe $21, and we send you everything. Not in this one, Johnny. Gotcha. We do have more Donruss Basketball on the site if you're really into this particular product. This is not the last one. We have break number four filling up on the site. So if you click on the link, jump over to our website, you will see break number four. You could snag up some teams in that one. That's not lined up tonight, but it is up there. Prices are very good. All right, guys, there it is. And guys, do make sure to follow our Breakers channel. Do make sure to follow our Twitch channel. Also subscribe to our YouTube channel so you'll know when we post our stuff over to YouTube. Pulling Ingram one of one auto or something. All right, Trickster, let's see if I can do it for you. Let's see what I can do. And again, guys, I'm not going to worry about flipping the orientation to the right side up because they just flip right back like within seconds. We got a press proof of LaMarcus Aldridge. Crashers. See what I'm saying? As soon as I go through like four cards, boom, the orientation flips back up. So there's really no point in it. Got a Fareed Crashers. However, it seems like the upside down orientation is more prevalent, isn't it? Why is that? All right, the champ is here, Dwayne Wade. Got a press proof of Carmelo to $2.99 on that one. All right, I'm going against my own thing here, and I'm flipping them right side up. Let's see how many cards it goes until they go. There it is. We got a rookie Kings. Rookie Kings for the Kings. Got a Hall Kings of Clyde the Glide. Hall Kings. All right. Working our way through. Got an All-Stars, LaMarcus Aldridge. He's showing up a lot, man. Showing up a lot. Got an All-Stars press proof. Golden State Warriors Draymond Green. Pretty cool card. Cooler for that ink on it. And some low numbering, but still pretty cool. Got an All-Stars of Larry Bird. Yeah, Aldridge is, he's in this one a lot. I see something coming up here. Something with the funky background. What is it? What is it? That's a Russell Westbrook to 49. That's pretty cool. 12 out of 49, Oklahoma City Thunder. Russell Westbrook. So to 49 qualifies with us as a hit. Anything 50 or better, any kind of relic card, any auto card, that is a hit. You do get all cards pulled for your team in addition to your hits. So we will take the painstaking effort to sort through all this stuff into team stacks, and you will get it all. Got an Isaiah Whitehead, Rookie Kings. Got a Hall Kings of Magic. All right, second half. Guys, I can see 50% of the break sitting there. After that box, that is. After that box, we will be 50% of the way through. The champ is here, Kyrie. Got a spacer right there. We got a press proof right here. Kemba Walker, Charlotte, to $1.99. Got a Court Kings of AD. Anthony Davis, Court Kings. We're waiting on that auto, right? We've already pulled the, or actually, are we waiting on both? Let's see. We'll see in this stack, won't we? We got a Bembry for the Hawks. That's to 99. Oh, there it is. I see Back to the Future, I think, is coming up. There it is. I can see it creeping out. Back to the Future. Hitting 88 miles an hour. Soon, Elite Series, Russell Westbrook. Here it comes. Marty McFly. What do we got? That is a Back to the Future, Reggie Jackson, Oklahoma City Thunder. There we go. That's a 134 out of 199, Back to the Future relic for the Thunder. So Thunder picking one up there. Thunder from down under. They're like a Chippendales group. They come to the casino all the time around here. The one casino in the Poconos, Mount Airy, gets those dudes constantly. They're like from Australia, I guess, right? 76ers to 99 on this McConnell. The rookies for the Suns. All right, spacer right there. So many spacers, so little time. All right, keeping it going. Got a press proof, Victor Oladipo to $2.99. Got an all-star as Anthony Davis. I need some acoustic foam. I need to put acoustic foam up on the walls in this joint, right around the area where we actually do the little the breaks from here. Elite Series Anthony Davis. Keep the volume focused toward the mic. And finishing it off right here. What do we got? And here it is, guys. Here it is. It's a Dominator. It's going to be an auto for the Clippers. Diamond Stone. Diamond Stone auto. And that is a 33 out of 65 with the little checkerboard background going on. Diamond Stone for them Clippers. Dominator auto. Who's got the Clippers? I guess Steve Ballmer actually really has the Clippers. But the Clippers belongs to Notorious RB. That's one of yours, right? Congrats, buddy. How is Steve Ballmer doing? If you guys follow a lot of that. Got a press proof here. Press proof to $2.99 for the Magic. Since Steve Ballmer actually bought the Clippers, how's the... is he trying to pull a page out of Cuban's book and kind of turn the team around and do all that good stuff? All right, one sec here, guys. Organizing all kinds of base. Organizing all kinds of base. All right, I'm officially one bucket of base filled up. Second bucket coming up. And like I said, this box right here represents halfway. So once we blaze through this box, we are going to be halfway through the break. I will do a hit recap on this one, guys, because I don't imagine too many folks are going to sit there and watch a two-hour video to see if they got a hit. They'll just wait for it to come in the mail. Look at this box. Just broke right open, right? See that action? So that box goes right in the garbage. Okay. Here we go. Let's start them on this side. Let's do this. Guys, High Tech Baseball would love to see it go next. It is sitting at 10. What do you guys say? Are we going to get it filled? I would like to get it filled. Jump on the website. It's right on the homepage. You can't miss it. Sitting on that homepage. Actually, speaking of which, let me take a quick look and see if Don Russ... Just want to make sure that... So High Tech is the closest right now. And that one's got 10 remaining spots. So guys, if you jump into the homepage of the website, you're gonna see High Tech sitting smack dab on the first product block on the homepage. So if you wanna jump into the one that is closest, that's the one, down to 10. We can blaze through that case in about 15 minutes. That's a quick case. So let's get that one filled up next. We'll jump right into it. I would not be opposed to doing anything else in addition to that, guys. So if you want to keep the momentum flowing on any additional basketball, too, Court Kings, Totally Certified, and so on. Trying to fill it all tonight. Or at least push as much spot pickups as we can into those. Guys, new releases this week also. I know I mentioned it earlier, but we have three new releases coming out this week, one coming out next week. So check out our break schedule page. You'll see which new releases are coming out. We have two of them on Wednesday, one on Thursday, and then NT is next week. NT was originally supposed to be this week, but they pushed it, so it's next week now. All right, there's one half. Here comes the second half. I can never get this right. No matter how many times I try to line it up so that I could just pick these packs right up and blaze them open, I never ever line them up right. That one's pretty thick, although I don't know if it's just a spacer, because there's a lot of spacers in this product. Emma, there we go. Anybody see Rogue One over the weekend? I did. It's pretty good. My nephew is a huge Star Wars fanatic, so of course he dragged me. Not dragged me, I wanted to see it anyway. But I did see it. All right, two more packs. And the last pack right here. There it is. Okay, here we go. Let's start on the left. All right. Got a rookie Kings. Thon McCurr. What do we got? Did I miss? Yeah, I almost did miss. These purple press proofs are tough to pick if they're upside down. Tough to pick out of a pile. 75 out of 199 Dallas Mavericks Harrison Barnes press proof. But again, guys, you get it all. So if by chance I did miss any of those press proofs, you're still going to get it. What do we got? Got a Karl Anthony Towns Court Kings. Karl Anthony Towns Court Kings. I see Alonzo Mourning popping up out back there. What's he all about? Let's see. Got a Hall Kings of Gary Payton. Alonzo Mourning. Got an All-Stars of Drummond for the Pistons. Oh, it's the champ is here. That was what the Alonzo was popping up there. The champ is here, Alonzo Mourning. There is a spacer. Right behind it, we have a press proof to 199 for the Jazz. All right, we are getting down to it. Guys, guess what? We're almost 50% of the way through. Almost. Not quite. Have I mentioned we're filling up high tech? Might have said it once or twice. Sitting at 10 spots. I'll give it about 25 minutes after we finish this, see if we can get it filled. Elite Series, Jimmy Butler. I'll blast it all over social media as well, direct links to the high tech case, unless it fills prior to ending this. All right, guys, it's auto time, and it's the T-Wolves, and it's a Chris Dunn. Who's got them T-Wolves? I know I looked it up once already, but let me verify. Minnesota T-Wolves, Notorious RB. Coming at you. What do we got? Boom. Boom. Chris Dunn. Otto. Nice little on card. There you go, my friend. Ryan B. picking one up. Right. Just saying that high tech is filling. I don't know. Just thought I'd let you know. All right. We keep going. We keep going. Press proof. Golden State to 299. Kevin Durant. Oh, Jason's having all kinds of fun in Vegas right now. I'm breaking cards. Not to say that this is not fun. Court Kings, Russell Westbrook, Oklahoma City. he's going to be picking up a lot of the slack come January because I am moving. So he's going to be the one-man show for like 3 weeks straight. We got an Isaiah Whitehead, a Brooklyn Nets, Press Proof, Rookie Kings. So he'll be the one-man show probably like middle to late January for at least 2 to 3 weeks straight. You might see my presence in emails a little bit, but aside from that, I know, I'm just busting ass, right? Just busting. Anybody that picks up a couple teams in high tech, though, that will most likely trigger the momentum for that one to go, guys. That's the way it goes. You guys know how it is. It's a momentum game. Once the single digits come along and two or three teams get picked up, we got a Hall Kings of Allen Iverson. A young Allen Iverson, right? Is that a young picture of him, right? Once guys see it's down to seven, eight, nine spots, that's when the flood comes in and we get something filled. Toronto Raptors press proof to 199. Got an all stars of John Wall. Why is it every time I say John Wall? What was the guy from America's Most Wanted? John Walsh, right? The guy who did America was the host of America's Most Wanted, who had the son who was abducted years prior that got him into the whole law enforcement thing. John Walsh, I believe it was. Got a Crashers of Karl Anthony Towns. There you go. Little Crashers. Karl Anthony Towns. Rookie Kings, Bender. Suns. All right, we got a spacer right there. We got a Batum for the Hornets to 99. 41 out of 99. All right. John Walsh. Yeah, John Walsh. Is that still on? I know it went off the air for a while and they brought it back in like a different version of itself. Jimmy Butler, Court Kings. I haven't had a TV subscription in like 10 years. I cut the cord. I was a really early adopter on the whole cutting the cord thing. I cut the cord on TV subscriptions like nearly 10 years ago. So I don't see like any of those shows. Check this out. Minnesota T-Wolves press proof out of 10. 7 out of 10 on this one. Is it Levine? Zach LaVine. Minnesota T-Wolves. Very nice. 7 out of 10 press proof for the T-Wolves. So nice low number on that one. And who is it? None other than LaMarcus Aldridge. Elite Series. So yeah, I actually have to like seek out the shows if I really want to see them. All right, guys. Next hit coming up is a Marquese Chris for the Suns. Who's got them Suns? Phoenix Suns in this one is one of Ryan's. Here you go, Ryan. What do we got? Newly crowned. Newly crowned for the Suns. Booyah. All right. Getting down to it here. Getting down to it. Press proof of LeBron. That's the 299. Got the rookies, Buddy Hield, Pelicans. And last little stack here. Once again, guys, thanks for filling this one up. More basketball filling, Court Kings, totally certified. Baseball filling, high tech, Bowman Draft Jumbo. I will break any or all that will fill in addition to this one. How about a Hall Kings press proof of none other than Larry Bird? Larry Bird, Hall Kings press proof. All right, that does it for that one. Give me a sec to organize up this base. And guys, we're halfway through. Booyah, halfway through. How about that optimism in my voice? Not that I'm in a rush, I am in zero rush. We've accomplished part of what we wanted to do, which is get some of this filled up tonight, and here we are, breaking it, having fun. All right. Xbox. Box number. That was 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh yeah, I threw one of the boxes. I'm looking at my empty boxes over here off to the side, and I'm like, why do we only show four of them? The one box fell apart on me, and I threw it in the garbage. So I'm like, man, are we not actually halfway through? I freaked myself out for a minute. But yes, we are halfway through. Five boxes still to rip. I'm going to see if I can pick up the pace. I'm going to see what we can do here. Because it's now 10:12, and we'll be at this for at least another hour. All right, there's an empty. Slugging the coffee down, guys. Don't mind me. Slugging down the Starbucks Pike Place. All right, here we go. Packing, unpacking. Everybody all geared up for the holiday? Ready for the holiday? Got all your shopping done? I know if you guys shop at Sam's Club. I'm a big fan of the Sam's Club. I shop and get a bunch of stuff at Sam's Club. I just became aware that Sam's Club has a Scan and Go app. So, if you have Sam's Club membership and you shop there quite often, highly suggest you get the Scan and Go app. How that works is you walk into the store, you load up your shopping cart. As you're putting items in your cart, you scan them with your phone. It loads up a subtotal for you built right into your account. You load a credit card right into your account. And basically you pay for it while you're just shopping, walking around the aisles. All you then have to do is go to the checkout, show your phone with a completed receipt to the person at the door, and you're done. You do not have to go through any checkout lines. The Dodgers holding up high tech. Another one of the big teams. Another one of the big ones. Well, Don P picked up the Cubs. So the Cubs got snagged. They were one of the big teams. They were $130-ish dollars, so they got snagged, so Don helped out the effort on that one. So if someone's got it in their budget to pick up the Dodgers, the other high team, the other more expensive team up there, it is a full case break, guys. Full case, not just boxes. Full sealed case. But back to my Sam's Club story. Yeah. Scan and Go app. All about it. Love me some Sam's Club. Nothing like a 5-gallon bucket of margarine to save the day. I just like getting coffee and stuff there. Coffee's great deals there. Whew, man. All right, here we go. Box number 6 has been unpacked. Here we go, starting on the left, and I'm going to try to get through these a little faster. Let's see if we can do that. Again, I'm only looking for press proofs. I'm looking for stuff like this, like the All-Star Russell Westbrook. All right, we got the champ is here, Dwayne Wade. Got a press proof right here. Jamal Murray, Denver Nuggets, press proof to 199. Got a Court Kings of Okafor. Court Kings. Okafor makes his first appearance here in something other than just a base. Got a Rookie Kings of, and I can never pronounce this dude's name, so I'm not even going to try. 76ers. You know who he is. Got a Hall Kings of Patrick Ewing. Got a spacer right there. Got a press proof. And again, guys, if I miss any of these press proofs that are upside down, sometimes they're a little tough to see. You're going to get it all. Andre Robertson for the Oklahoma City Thunder, press proof to $299. I'm just trying to keep at this at a little bit faster pace now. We have a Kevin Love Crashers for the Cavs. All right, we got a press proof here. Isaiah Whitehead, Brooklyn Nets, press proof to $199. Got a Rookie Kings, Chris LeVert for Brooklyn Nets. Got a David Robinson Hall Kings. Bad luck with high tech, Kyle. Yeah, I mean, I guess it can go that way because there's a few, like, a low amount of cards in that product. So there's a low amount of cards. So you're either going to get, you know, you're going to be on the good side or the bad side when there's a low amount of cards. When you're on the good side, feels great. When you're on the bad side, not so great. All-Stars, John Wall, America's Most Wanted. That's like, sometimes we'll get these inquiries from guys on eBay. Press proof, Frank Kaminsky, Charlotte Hornets to $299. And they'll come in inquiring about a product like NT or Flawless or something like that. And they'll be like, I've never done breaks before. I want to get in this break. And they're looking to buy like one of the $300 spots. I almost have to talk them out of it. I almost literally want to talk them out of like buying into something high-end like that for their first break. Because I think it's going to sour them unless their team gets absolutely smashed with hits. All-Stars, Drummond. Unless their team gets just destroyed, smashed over the head with a massive hit, they're probably going to be soured toward doing breaks ever again when they buy into something high-end like that for their first break. Elite Series, Kyle Lowry. They're much better off getting into something like a lot of guys that are just getting into the whole hobby and getting into breaks, getting into something like middle of the road where they have a much bigger potential to score some hits. All right, guys, here we go. What do we got? Artis Gilmore, San Antonio Spurs Dominator, Hall Dominator. What do we got? Boom. A little old school. Check out the old school San Antonio uniform even. Gilmore, Spurs. Henry Owens sours me on life. San Antonio Spurs. Is K-Dubs. K-Dubs picking this one up. K-Dubs picking that one up. There you go. But you know what I'm saying. Like, if you're new to breaks in general and you've never participated and you want to jump into something without having a ton of knowledge on the whole thing of what it's all about, and you're jumping into something like an NT, it's probably not the best move. All right, we have a little eBay one of one action on the numbering here. One out of 199 press proof Ricky Rubio for those T-Wolves. Got a Court Kings of Dirk Nowitzki. All right. Spacer right there. Check out the worm. Check out the worm. We got a Hall Kings press proof Dennis Rodman. Pretty cool. In full crazy head, bleached hair look. Not with the wedding dress, but got a Court Kings, Serge Ibaka. Is Dennis Rodman broke now? Is that the word? Did I hear or see that or read that somewhere that Dennis Rodman, because he was living pretty high, even for several years after his career was over, he was living pretty high on the Vegas life and all kinds of stuff. Toronto Raptors to 99. Elite Series Klay Thompson for Golden State right behind it. I mean, what's broke to one of these guys though? They only have, 7 million left in the bank instead of 65. I don't know. It's like that. Here we go. What do we got? This is gonna be a good one, guys. I can kind of. This is gonna be a good one, I think. Don't quote me. Brooklyn Nets. Who's got them Nets? Brooklyn Nets. K Dubs. What do we got for you, bud? I'm taking a peek. That's a pretty good one. That's a pretty cool patch right there. Check it out. Newly crowned. Yeah, that is a good one. That's a 3 out of 10. I thought it was bigger. That's why I was thinking it was going to be cooler, but that's still pretty darn cool. And that numbering is awesome. Newly crowned Chris LeVert, Brooklyn Nets. Got the B going on here, don't you? Nice little B patch. That's pretty cool. 3 out of 10. Nice low numbering. So the hits that have been coming out of this have been pretty good. Pretty good indeed. I'm sure you guys have seen that 30 for 30 broke. Speaking of broke sports stars, press proof to 199 for the Kings, which basically goes into that whole phenomena of a lot of these NFL guys that come out of the league and within like 3 years they're broke. It's mind-blowing. Ben Simmons, the rookies. Wish it had some ink on it. Wish it had some low number on it, but not yet. That's a spacer. That's a DeMarcus Cousins press proof Court Kings. All right, that does it. Four boxes to go, guys. Four boxes to go. Yeah, a little Simmons love. Little Simmons action. Those little inserts are worth a little something something. Sometimes they're even worth more than I would give them credit for, even without numbering on them, just because of the player on them. I remember, what was it? Oh, last year there was a product that might have had, was it Okafor? And like just his base cards and the one product were supposedly going for something like $15. And I'm like, what? There's nothing on it. Can't remember what it was. Can't remember which product. All right, here we go. Box number six. I'm sorry, seven. My bad. Seven. Three to go after this one. High tech still sitting at 10. I'm gonna keep saying it. You guys are gonna hate me. But we gotta keep pushing them. Gotta keep pushing them to fill. All right, there's all the packs. Here we go. Once again, I never orientate the packs the right way to just blaze through them. That's the way. What time do we got? 10:30-ish. Going on 10:30. We should be done with this one, hopefully within a half hour. And if we can get high tech filled, that should only take about 15 to 20 minutes. Okay, there's one half. Let's get the second half unpacked here. I'm gonna need to step outside into like the 18 degree weather after this break just to get a breath of fresh air. High tech down to 8. Fantastic. Notorious RB, you sir are really helping things out tonight, and we do appreciate it, bud. We do appreciate it. Took the Dodgers and the Giants. Guys, the big team is off the board now, the Dodgers. So if you were looking at that break and saying, oh, this isn't going to go because nobody's going to step up on that big team, Ryan just stepped up on the big team. So thank you very much, Ryan. Much appreciated, bud. You're going to have a nice discount next month, too. You will be in the full 12.5% bracket on that one. I'm not sure where you fall this month, if you fall into that bracket or not, but you will next month. Plus, guys, when you do fall into those brackets, you actually get in the running for some free break cash as well. We do giveaways every month. So you will have the potential not only to save 12.5% on every spot that you pick up on the site, but you will have the potential for some free cash courtesy of us. We got a Bryce Johnson to 99 for the Clippers. But thank you very much, Ryan, greatly appreciated, bud. 10 this month, so yeah, you'll definitely be hitting the 12.5 next month. The Elite Series, Chris Paul. Oop. I think Kyle was at 12.5 this month. All right, guys, what do we got? We got some Swatch Kings, Boston Celtics, Marcus Smart. Boom. Swatch Kings, Boston Celtics. Picking up the relic here, 67 out of 99, Marcus Smart, Swatch Kings. I hear Swatch and I immediately think of the watches from the 80s, the plastic watches, which made a retro comeback, I think, in recent years. Swatches, I think there's even stores around the bigger cities of Swatch now, which is pretty crazy, considering that was like when I was a kid. 14 out of 299, press proof, Dallas Mavs. And they had all kinds of crazy crap for those watches, like little guards and all stuff. What a scam. Dimes, Ricky Rubio. T-Wolves. All right. Spacer right there. All right. Court Kings. Mudeai. Press proof for the Nugs. Wookenpa Nug. Got an All-Stars, John Wall. Keeping it going. We got an All-Stars of Dwayne Wade. All right, here we go. Sacramento Kings getting the next hit. How do you say this guy's name? Malachi Richardson? Is it like the Malachi Crunch from Happy Days? What do we got? Boom! Very nice. Not just ink, but ink with a little jersey piece going on here. 60 out of 75, Sacramento Kings. That's the Malachi Crunch for sure. Who's got them Kings? Sacramento Kings, Ryan B. What's up, Ryan B? There you go. 60 out of 75. Boom. I like it. I like it a lot. All right, let's keep this thing going. We got a Kobe, the champ, is here. We got a press proof to 299, Jake Layman for the Trailblazers. And guys, if you didn't hear me mention it a couple minutes ago, Ryan just picked up 2 out of the 10 teams that are remaining in high tech, so we're down to 8. Let's get that one filled. We'll jump right into it next. Be a nice night. We'll have 2 breaks. Court Kings, LeBron. What was the movie LeBron was in just recently with Bill Hader from SNL? Was it Trainwreck? Was it that Amy Schumer movie? Was that what it was? I think it might have been that. Was it that? But LeBron played himself, and Bill Hader was like a sports doctor or something like that. We got to check this out. Dimes Press Proof Steph Curry. That's a pretty cool card right there for a non-hit. That's a pretty cool card. Steph Curry, press proof dimes. Nice. Got a Dominique Hall Kings. All right, 1 half down. That was it. It was Trainwreck, the Amy Schumer movie. He was actually pretty funny in that. Got a Clippers card, Jordan to 49. Nice. DeAndre Jordan, LA Clippers, and that is a 36 out of 49. All right. Court Kings, Oladipo. Yeah, that was pretty good. Was that the one that also had, what's his face in it? John Cena? John Cena played like the previous boyfriend. What I'm thinking about, there's all kinds of weird like cameo roles being played in that movie. Just got back into the room. Oh yeah, still got 3 boxes to get through there, Paul. Still got 3 boxes, buddy. I'll do a hit recap when I finish it up. But Paul, if you're interested, we're down to 8 spots now in high tech. Ryan picked up. Who'd you pick up there, Ryan? The Dodgers. The Dodgers and the Giants were picked up in high tech. Ryan B. over on Twitch, Notorious RB, picked them up. Tell me he doesn't look like... that facial shot doesn't look like Kanye West real quick. Got a Crashers. DeMarcus Cousins. So if you want to see that one go tonight, Paul... We are at 8 in high-tech baseball break number 4. The big team, the Dodgers, is off the board. So all very, very affordable teams still up for grabs in that one. Awesome, awesome, awesome. That'll probably put us right around the time that we're going to be wrapping up the final 3 boxes and the hit recap here, Paul. So that'll work out great. So looks like hopefully we're going to get that one off the ground tonight, guys. High-tech baseball. Got a rookie Kings for Toronto. All right, I'm going to do it just because it seems like every card I'm doing is upside down. And watch, I'm going to go through 2 cards. Holy crap, exactly 2 cards, and it goes upside down again. Here we go, press proof time. Press proof. Washington Wizards to 299, John Wall. Anybody a big fan of like the Netflix original series? I see they put a new one out this past weekend. Kind of shrouded in mystery. Girl comes back after being gone for like 7 years or something, and she was like blind, and now she could see, or she was deaf, and now she could hear, or something like that. Got an All-Stars of Drummond for the Pistons. Can't remember the name, but it's like the OA or the O something. Rookie Kings. For New Orleans. Get some jambalaya. All right. Last little stack. 3 boxes still to crack open. We got a Hall Kings, Patrick Ewing. Spacer right there. We got a Roberson Oklahoma City Thunder press proof to 199. Court Kings, Chris Paul, Clippers. All right, that does it for that box. Three boxes still left to crack open. One sec. Opening. Open all three at the same time? I'd have a mess. I don't have a big enough workspace here, Trickster. It would be like insanity going on here. Insanity Wolf, if you will. One of my favorite internet memes. One sec, organizing up all this base. Three boxes still to crack open. All right, here we go. Box number 8. Holy moly. Box number 8 right now. I'm blown away by the fact that there's still three boxes. I said to Jason, after I cracked open the first one, I said I was physically worn out after having broken open the first one of these. And he was laughing at it until he did the next one. And he was like, holy shit. That was painful. It is a little painful, I gotta say. Like, they're fun to get through, but man, there's a lot of cards. You don't want to skimp on them. You don't want to skimp and just blaze through super fast and look for the two hits and that's it. You want to show those inserts and stuff. Some guys will do that. Some guys on breakers. Yeah, some guys on breakers just boom, boom, boom. They're flipping through them. It's like, I don't know. That's just not the way I do it. I know that means that the breaks take forever to actually look at on camera, but I don't know. I just feel like, you know, you guys are paying for this. You want to see these cards opened up in real time. Sorting these is a beast. Luckily, we have some sorting help on some of this real heavy base stuff now. But before that, it was just Jason and myself doing it all. We still do most of it. We only pass off these real big, heavy base ones to Jason's brother. He helps us. Of course, he's not doing it out of courtesy. He's doing it for a little extra, you know, little cabbage. We pay him a little something. But we're not a big enough operation to have somebody that just does it and gets paid for it. Although, if you really think about it, we probably would be able to push more breaks out the door if we didn't have to worry about all those details on the back end, like the sorting and the packing and the shipping. So it's like, you know, you got to weigh the sides. What do we want to be? We're kind of, you know, we're a nice middle of the road breaking operation. Not the biggest, not the smallest. We kind of like that. Kind of like where we fall into the hierarchy. All right, here we go. Next half. Guys, Court Kings Basketball 17, totally certified Basketball 17. If you want to keep the basketball love going, even if they don't get filled tonight, if we, you know, you guys pick up any spots on those, I will put them back on the schedule either for tomorrow. Yeah. Yeah, exactly, Pablo. I mean, those guys do their thing and they do it well. You know, we are not that operation, nor do we really want to be. Jason works a full-time day job. I have other interests in addition to this one. So we are not doing this full-time, even though it might seem like we do. But yeah, Platinum and the rest of those guys that do it on a much bigger scale than we do, that's awesome. If they can keep that going, fantastic. But it's not really who we want to be. So we kind of, we like our place in the breaking scheme and we'll probably stay right there. You know, going any bigger is just going to be too much time, effort, and commitment that neither one of myself nor Jason want to put into it. So where we currently are at is probably where we will be, which is anywhere from like 10 to 15, 16 breaks a week, which is a good number for us. We can realistically get all that stuff out the door, plus keep the operation going on the sales side and the promotional side and all that good stuff. So anything more than that, and we'd have to have additional people helping us with it. And not really looking to be there. Oh, you're one of the Platinum hosts? I didn't even realize they had such a thing as hosts. How do How does that work? You broke some of the cards, like you would actually do the breaks for them, or how do they work that? We got a Thaddeus Young, 63 out of 99, Pacers. Made fun of one of the people on the stream. Oh, it was one of the platinum hosts. My bad. I misread what you said there. Thaddeus Young, Pacers, 63 out of 99. I'm half reading the chat going in, and I'm trying to sort through, flip these cards out too. We got a Kyrie Court Kings. Turned out to be someone that works for them. I gotcha. I gotcha. Yeah, I mean, this channel, Breakers.tv, is truthfully like the Wild West. It's like the Wild West. I mean, there's a lot of guys pulling some shady stuff. I mean, we are as up and up as you can be, and that's really the way we try to be. We price everything where we need to. Got a Jimmy Butler, the Elite Series. And if it's not within guys' budgets, they'll come at us with venom and say, like, we're charging too much. But hey, we don't get this stuff off the back of a truck. We're paying big money for these cases. We're paying big money for this stuff, so we need to get our investment back and have a little bit for our time and effort. All right, we got T-Wolves. Swatch Kings, Zach LaVine again. Minnesota T-Wolves, what do we got for you this time? Very nice. That is a 98 out of 99 this time. Swatch Kings, T-Wolves. And we're not getting rich on this stuff. There are some guys out there that overcharge. I will not mention any names, but some of the guys that have been out there in the industry for a long time that seem to have breakers that kind of drink the Kool-Aid and will not go anywhere else. We got a Bradley Beal, Washington Wizards, press proof. That's the 299. Their customers will not even price, like, shop around and actually shop pricing. They'll just take the word for that breaker. Steph Curry dimes again. And I've done pricing comparisons on our prices versus their prices. And I'm not talking about just one particular breaker. There's probably three or four of them out there. And they're charging double, maybe even sometimes 2.5 to 3 times the prices that we're charging. Dirk Nowitzki, the champ, is here. But I guess if they can get it, and that has to cover all the overhead of having those additional people on staff and doing all that, then more power to them. Got a Whitehead press proof to 199 there for Brooklyn. And if guys are willing to pay it because they like the operation that these guys have going, then it's all good. Everybody can charge whatever price they want to. It's a free and open market on that. Yeah, they make a bunch off eBay bids too, of snipers bidding shit up. That is a real thing. Like eBay, we put our stuff on eBay really as a secondary marketplace to get exposed, to be exposed to a whole new subset of people that might not know of us. Rookie Kings, Chris Dunn. But eBay is a real cutthroat place. Like, there are some guys selling break spots on eBay, starting the bids at 99 cents. Okay? There's no way you can sell a $100 team at $19 where those bids end. So what's really going on there? The Elite Series, Klay Thompson. There was one guy that used to break here on Breakers.tv pretty regularly. I don't see him around very much anymore. But he was a big one. Like, you would look at his eBay listings, and if you know how to really use eBay and search completed listings, you can search his completed listings and look at like a whole 30 team break. And over the course of those 30 teams, he was essentially, quote unquote, losing $400. All right, guys. I'll get back into my rant in a second here. We have a rookie dominator for the Rockets. How do you pronounce this guy's name? Chenenu? I'm not even going to try. That guy. That guy. That's a 33 out of 65 rookie dominator auto for the Rockets. Rockets, who's got them? Houston Rockets. That's Chris P. Chris P picking that one up. There you go, Chris. The average cost to ship over the course of, like, we do an average over like the 10 to 12 or 15 breaks we do for the whole week, about like $3.50 per package. So about 300 and, I mean, I don't know, 300 to 500 bucks in shipping we're putting out of pocket per week. to get this stuff shipped. If you're in the domestic US and you buy off of our website, we don't charge for shipping. If you're buying off eBay, we charge $3.50 for shipping. Although then we have other guys like this stuff. We'll have guys, a lot of international buyers come in on basketball, and we'll have guys in like Australia or someplace like that that might have four or five team spots in something like a Donruss. That one package might cost us $50 to ship it. We're not charging that guy $50, but it's kind of subsidized by the other guys that are paying $3 on eBay. So, got a press proof. Brooklyn Nets. But what I was saying about the guys that are charging are starting their auctions at 99 cents and ending a $100 team with a winning bid at like $9 or $19. We got a Ralph Sampson Hall Kings. There's just no way they're doing it. There's absolutely no way they're doing it. So either A, they literally are taking a $400 loss on the product, or B, they're making it look like they sell all teams just to kind of save face. But in fact, they're keeping, say, 20 out of the 30 teams themselves. Got a press proof to 199, Willie Cauley-Stein. Sacramento. Like I said, doing it to save face and essentially subsidizing the cost of their case with the few teams that actually do sell for legit prices. Got an Isaiah Thomas All-Stars. It's the only thing we could figure. Because there's no way you could take a $400 loss on a case of cards over and over and over again. Maybe once in a great while, if you have a dog of a product that just will not sell, you can just kind of bite your lip and take a loss. Some guy was trying to sell every team for a one box break of five star, a break of two cards. Wow, yeah. One box case. Oh man. There's a lot of crazy stuff that goes on out there with guys selling this stuff. There's a lot. Got a rookie Kings. There you go. Little Ben Simmons rookie Kings. So the nicest Ben Simmons yet. Rookie Kings of him. They have their pals putting in bids. Yeah, the shill bidding is a real thing. The shill bidding on eBay is a real thing. We don't even fool around and get into the bidding stuff. If we do auction style breaks, got a Court Kings press proof, DeMar DeRozan for the Raptors. If we do auction style breaks, it's usually the older stuff just to get a new audience coming our way. And what we'll do is say a case cost us 500 bucks. We'll take 500 divided by 30, pad in the extra for the fees because eBay charges 10% on the final value plus the PayPal is like 2.9. So all said and done, it's about 13, 13.5% fees. So to break even on the case is where we start our biddings at. 299 press proof, Pistons. So we don't even get down into that crazy like, oh my God, I'm gonna get a $60 break spot for $2. Because it's stupid. It's not realistic. Court Kings, Jimmy Butler. The only guaranteeing the buyer an autographed business card to skirt the eBay rules. Yeah, I mean, we have something similar on our eBay listings saying you're buying a top loader. In addition to the top loader, we are going to give you a spot in a group break. So eBay does have restrictions on offering breaks on the site, so you do have to kind of skirt those rules a little bit. Got a Hall Kings of Chris Mullin. Just to be able to offer breaks on eBay. I mean, it is a market that has kept us afloat in our lull times. Got a Steve Nash All-Stars. $25,000 per case, and 65 cases were sold in a day. Yeah, and then the cards were falling apart with the glue, right? Yeah, the Transcendent. From what I read, it was on Beckett, and some of the guys were posting the link here that the cards in the Transcendent, a bunch of the cases were actually kind of defective and falling apart. The framed cards were, the glue was not good. How about that product? So the product was being sold for like 25 or 27,000 or something like that, pre-sale. And then once the product came out, I think I heard it dropped down to like 22,000. So whatever was still available was still out there, but you can now snag those cases for like 22K. which has to be a real burn for the guys that ponied up the big bucks and the full price for it pre-release. Yeah, if you look on Beckett's website, they had an article up there about Transcendent and the glue falling apart on it. The glue coming apart on the framed cards. Gotta go look at the high tech, see if I might be interested in it. All right, Rob, what's up, buddy? Rob K in the house. Guys, I'm sitting here chatting it up, and I appreciate the conversation. But in the meantime, I'm looking at the numbers on high tech. High tech is now down to 6. So booyah, we could be breaking high tech right after this one goes off. I appreciate those pickups, guys. So 2 extra spots were picked up in the meantime, so we are at 6. Let's see where we go. Let's go here. Breaking up the case and hit drafts. I mean, hit draft makes sense for high-end product for sure, because everybody is at least getting value. Yeah, everybody's getting value on that. So, I don't know. One of our breakers that breaks with us actually has a case of it and was offering it to us for a pretty good price. And I just said it's just out of our... We wouldn't be able to sell it. They sold out of all the cases. What they did with the one-of-one cut autographs is a joke. Yeah, I didn't look too much into it, but I got to really look back into that. 25,000. What the F? We have a tough time sometimes selling, like... For instance, we did Immaculate Football as a random division. And, you know, we have to sell. There's 8 spots instead of 32. So, basically, do the math on it. We have to sell them for X amount of dollars to make a tiny bit of profit, plus get our money back on the investment of the case. We sometimes just struggle to sell that kind of stuff off because guys don't want to step up. And no offense to anybody hanging out watching on Breakers, but I understand there's budgets and you guys, there's only so much disposable income to go around. It's a certain kind of breaker that's going to step up on a $200 or $300 spot. But I couldn't even fathom what you'd have to charge on a $25,000 case. We would never be able to sell it. Although it might shock me. All of a sudden it might sell off like much better than I thought it would. It looks, I don't know, how is the briefcase? It looks just like a flawless briefcase to me from the outside. I haven't seen the inside of them. Looks exactly like a flawless briefcase. Is it like a Halliburton, like, you know, one of those Halliburton pieces of luggage that are can be dropped out of a jet and still survive? All right, I'm going to try to blaze through these 2 boxes pretty quickly. What do we got? 5 to 11. So 6 remaining teams in high tech. I think Paul said he was going to snag a couple of, he was going to pull over off to the side of the road. He was traveling. He was going to pull over and snag up a couple teams. All right, there are the 2 stacks. I wonder what those empty Transcendent briefcases are selling for on eBay. We, when we were doing Flawless stuff, we would sell the briefcases for like, $15.99 shipped on eBay. Because they do still have some value, those Flawless briefcases. I can't even fathom how much the $25,000 Transcendent cases were going for, though. Got an Elite Series, Dirk Nowitzki. All right, we got a Back to the Future. I can see it. I can see it facing me. Twin Pines Mall coming up. Here it is. That is a Paul Gasol. That is the Lakers. That is Back to the Future. 195 out of 199. Flux capacitor and all. Boom. All right, keeping it going, guys. Keeping it going. The Twin Pines Mall. Got a press proof. Phoenix Suns to 299, Booker. We got dimes. Dimes of Chris Paul Clippers. Nice. Thank you, Rob. Jump on in, guys. Guess what, guys? We're down to four. We are down to four in high tech. Down to four in high tech. Let's do it. Ooh, I picked up the spacer and that card clung right to the back of it. That's a Hall Kings. That's a spacer, though. That's a Hall Kings press proof of Dantley. That card clung right to that spacer. How about it? We got a hit coming up. We got a hit coming up. I'm peeking at it right now. We'll see it in a second. We'll see it in just a second. Let's see what we got in front of it, though, if anything. Got an All-Stars, Leonard. Elite Series, LeBron. Guys, I'm going to need 5 minutes in between the breaks, though, if we get that one filled up, just to kind of catch my breath. This one's a beast, man. It's a beast. All right, here we go. It's hit time. And it is for the Houston Rockets. I'm not going to try to pronounce this guy's name again. But, whoo, baby, check it out. That is very nice. That's a 6 out of 75. Houston Rockets, little two-color action going on. What do we got? Houston Rockets is Chris P. Chris P picking up. I believe I called your name for another Rockets hit a short while ago, but that is a good one right there, buddy. 6 out of 75. Booyah. Very nice. As we move forward, press proof. Pelicans 299. Court Kings, Court Kings, DeMar DeRozan, Raptors. About another three, Rob? Fantastic, my friend. Fantastic. Guys, you are helping out the effort big time this week. I'm a one-man show, and you guys are making it worthwhile. So, really appreciated. Both myself and Jason do appreciate it. Got a Court Kings press proof, Serge Ibaka. Got an All-Stars, LaMarcus Aldridge. All right, one half done. Guys, guess what? One box and one half a box still to look at. Then this lovely break is over. Let's see what else we can pull, though. Let's see what else we can pull. I think the hits were officially pulled out of this, so we're looking for low-numbered stuff now. Murray to 299 press proof. I will do a hit recap on this one once I finish it up before I get into high tech. Guys, I see the high tech numbers going down, down to three. Got a Derrick Rose Knicks. Even though he's wearing a Bulls uniform, you can see the Knicks logo on there. Derrick Rose, Court Kings for the Knicks. Hey, now you're an all-star, Anthony Davis. Rookie Kings, Sabonis. Got a spacer right there. We got a Brogdon press proof for the Bucks, 199. Three left in high tech. You guys are the best. I was about to drop an F-bomb right there. Didn't want to do that. Try to keep the channel family friendly. I know a lot of guys drop F-bombs and all kinds of crazy stuff. But I like to keep it family friendly. Scottie Pippen Hall Kings. You guys are the effing best. I'll say that. The champ is here. Dwayne Wade. Got a Gortat press proof to 199. And we keep going forward. Crashers, Dwight Howard. Ooh, baby. All right, rookie Kings, Chris for the Suns. Six spots in tech. Tap down the funds. That's all good, Rob. Much appreciated on the effort you put in, buddy. Much appreciated. Guys, do share links back to our site. If you participate in any message forums and any Facebook breaking groups, things like that, you know, don't be afraid to post a link to your favorite breaking operation, and hopefully that favorite is us. We got a Hall Kings Chris Mullen. So share a link, sportsboxbreaks.com, or even sbb.rip, our little short link. That'll take you right to the homepage of our site. So you can even link it using sbb.rip or sportsboxbreaks.com. Either one will take you directly to the homepage. We got a Hamilton Press Proof Oklahoma City Thunder to 199. But the more folks know about our site and the more guys come in and break with us on the regular, the bigger the group, the more breaks we can offer, the different type of breaks we can offer. So we do ask that you do get the word out. We got a Court Kings of Wiggins. Court Kings of Wiggins. All right. 1 sec. Organizing base. Last box coming up. Last box coming up. I'm laughing at your I'm laughing at your comment there, Rye. Oh, gonna have to turn tricks. Tricks are for kids. All right. Ooh, baby. I'm taking a sip of my coffee to keep me going on the last box. Here we go, guys. Box 10. Box 10. 1104. Again, I'm in no rush. I'm just saying the time for my own sake of knowing what the heck time it is. We've been at it since 8. And there's an empty. So the live sessions, as you guys know, are pretty much just the end result of all the effort we put out. We get a lot of this stuff sold outside of the live breaks. But still, you kind of have to do the promotion and push this stuff during the live break time. I keep picking them up the wrong way. All right, there we go. A lot of guys here on Breakers don't do any, it doesn't seem like they do anything outside of Breakers. They just go live. And if guys come in and buy their breaks during their live sessions, that's what happens. We, on the other hand, do all kinds of promotion and effort outside of the live breaks. In a more traditional, like, e-commerce marketing sense. Buying wax is addicting. Well, we appreciate all the pickups, but guys, of course, don't overextend yourself. Said no retailer ever, right? But I mean, we want to keep guys sustainable in the hobby with us. You know, there's basically two types of guys that buy into this stuff. There's guys that are building up collections, and there's guys that are reselling. And then there's kind of a hybrid of the two, guys that do a little of both. Guys that resell and build up their collection with some of the more premium stuff that they get pulled from the breaks. Hey, we'll work with anybody. But the guys that are coming in and buying and building up personal collections, a lot of times, and this is not directed at anybody, but based on budgets, at some point your disposable funds probably run out and you say to yourself, like, I've built up enough, I'm going to stop buying. So if you resell, that's awesome for us because then you keep coming in and filling up our breaks. So or a little bit of both. Buying in, reselling a little bit, personal collecting a little bit. That kind of buyer stays sustainable as well. Ingram is 75. Nice. Nice, nice. Between teams here, you also buy some of your own wax, Kyle. Nice. Kyle, I think I was saying it to you one time a couple days ago or last week on the live stream, but we can typically get better prices, us directly, than even somebody like a Dave and Adams or a Blowout Cards. So reach out to us if you're looking to buy your own full boxes, and we can price stuff out for you. So when and if, and this goes for everybody, guys, just send us an email and say, hey, I'm looking for a full box or three full boxes of, you know, Don Russ basketball. What can you do for me on price? We'll look to see what Dave and Adams is selling it for. We'll look to see what Blowout is selling it for, and we'll see what we can get it for. And we're usually somewhere lower than both Dave and Adams and Blowout. So we'll sell you full sealed cases or full sealed cases or boxes if you want. Or we'll even do them as a personal break for you, personal box break. Or we've even done full personal case breaks for guys over the in the past. Trickster, like the base cards. Well, let's see if we can pull something for you in the last one here, Trickster. Let's see if we can pull something for you in the last box here, buddy. All right, here we go. Here we go, here we go, here we go. Prince Fielder green to 99 out of platinum here at Kmart. They have them. Very cool. All right, here we go. Let's see what we can pull out of box number 10. This has been a pretty good case. Let's spread some hits around to some other teams. We got a Brooklyn Nets press proof to 299. Guys, high tech is at 3. Are we going to get it filled very soon? Let's do it. We got a Chris Paul All-Stars Clippers. All right, keeping it going. Dwight Howard Crushers. Rookie Kings for the Suns. Spacer right there. We got so many spacers built up, they are going right in the garbage. There they go. All right, press proof to 299 for the Celtics. Court Kings, Isaiah Thomas, Boston. The Elite Series, John Wall, Washington. All right, we're getting there. We are getting there. Can we fill the second half of the case? All right, here we go. I don't physically have the other Don Russ basketball here at this location, if that's what you're talking about there, Trickster. The other 10 boxes actually exist at Jason's location. All right, guys, here we go. We got a Malachi Richardson again, if that's how you pronounce his name. So this is the second time we're seeing him. What do we have? Newly crowned Sacramento Kings. Sacramento Kings. So the other half... The other break number 4 of Don Russ Basketball will be scheduled for probably next Monday or Tuesday. We'll see how it shakes out because I don't have it here. Sunday is the holiday, so it won't be on Sunday. Got a press proof of Kyrie to 299. So it will have to be one of the days next week beyond Sunday. Got a Dimes Chris Paul for the Clippers. Selection of wax that no one seems to buy. Except is that right, Kyle? The Target. They have a good selection of cards and nobody buys it up. There's an empty spacer. What do we got? All Stars, press proof, Kevin Durant, Oklahoma City. Rookie Kings, Bryce Johnson, Clippers. All right, what are we looking for? We're looking for that auto. So we're looking for the auto in here. And there it is. I split the stack right at it. So we'll see that in a second. What do we have in front of it? What do we have in front of it? Elite Series, Leonard for the Spurs. Three spots still remain in high tech, guys. Let's get it filled. We can jump right into it next. I mean, it'll definitely go. Ooh, what do we got? We got a bonus coming on here because we pulled that newly crowned. So we're definitely with the little bonus material. Ooh, baby, what? Jamal Murray, 47 out of 75, Denver Nuggets. Denver Nuggets. That's Ryan B. Yeah, with the yellow and all. 47 out of 75. There you go. Nice, Ryan. Very nice. And I say bonus because that one's flipped upside down. So that's going to be an auto, I think. It should be. And we pulled that one relic card already. So this should be a bonus in this one. So let's see what we got here. Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. For the Pistons, Detroit Pistons belong to Adam P. Adam P with the Pistons. What do we got for you, buddy? Oh, I freaked out. I'm sorry, guys. It was flipped upside down, which usually indicates that it's an auto. And I tricked us out. They tricked me out by placing it in there the wrong way. I apologize, guys. I didn't mean to get hopes up. Let's see what else we got. Low numbered. Let's make up for it here, Panini. We got a Kobe. The champ is here. Kobe. Champ is here. We got a Jordan Mickey to 49. So nice low numbering on the Celtics. 49. Boston. All right. Gosh darn, Panini. You tricked us right the heck out. We got a Court Kings Lillard for Portland. These breaks are literally like enough to they punch you a little bit, man. So long to get through. Instant replay of that for later. I know. Press proof AJ Hammond's Rookie Kings for the Mavericks. Got us all excited and took it away. What do we got? Murray, Rookie Kings for the Spurs. We officially pulled our two hits out of this one. Let's see if we have any other low number something going on here. Denver Nuggets press proof to 199. Thought they gave us a bonus. At least there isn't any points. Yeah. Knock on wood, right? All of a sudden they'll slip one in. 4 points cards out of last night's break. One of the breaks last night. What the heck was it? Can't remember right now. 4 points cards. A 400 and then four two or three 250s. We got a Shaq. Shaq Hall Kings. All right, guys, getting down to it. Getting down to it. Last little stack here. This represents all of it. This is all that's left. Let's see what else we got. Steph Curry base. We got an All-Stars, James Harden. A swatch of James Harden's beard. Not really. All right, we got a spacer right there. We have for the Atlanta Hawks, Paul Millsap. 2 out of 99. 2 out of 99 in the Millsap. Loves a rainy night. Is that even the guy? It's like a 70s song. Ben Simmons bass. Rookie Kings of Sabonis. And that is all she wrote. Again, guys, thank you very much for filling that one. That was 2016-17 Don Russ basketball break number three. Break number four currently filling on the site. I will do a hit recap. Thank you, Trickster. Appreciate it, bud. I'll do a hit recap on this one before I even get into anything else. So I'm going to leave those hits right there in front of me. And guys, if you're watching this on YouTube, jump in more of our breaks. Link is down below in the description to participate in our breaks. Hope to see you in them.